In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the statistics menu and lists to do translations and reflections of polygons. So you're going to be able to enter points, the coordinates of the vertices of a polygon, using lists, and then we're going to use list calculations to do some transformations of those polygons. So the first thing we need to do, we're in the Casio fx-9860GII, and we need to go to the statistics menu and click execute. That starts it, and you'll see that we have our list. And what we're going to do is enter list 1 and list 2 as our x and y values in our coordinate of the vertices. So we have a triangle here, and it's got its three vertices. And so I'm going to identify, you can use the subheadings here for your list to kind of identify each. So I want this to be the x. So notice I have a little red x above the plus sign, which is the alphabet x. So I'm going to choose the red alpha key and hit the plus sign and then execute to enter it. And so now I've identified list one as my x values. And I'm going to do the same thing here. Alpha, the subtract button for the Y, hit execute. So now I've just simply identified what each list represents. And now I'm going to enter my coordinates. Now, if I want to actually see the triangle, I want the vertices to be connected with a line. So I need to basically enter that first coordinate that I decide to put in twice so that the line knows to come back to the beginning. So you'll see I'm going to enter the X values in the order that I have them there on my sheet. But I'm going to enter this first one a second time so that when I actually graph and connect these with a line, that the calculator knows to connect back to the beginning point. So now let's enter our y coordinates. So we have 1, and each time I'm entering a value, I hit execute to set it. And now I'm going to enter that first point again. So I've entered my coordinate and my vertices, the first one twice, so that it would come back. And now I need to make sure my graph is set up. So you'll notice here underneath the list options, I have things I can do. I can do calculations and tests, but I want to go to graph. So when I go to graph, there's three possible statistical graphs. So first I want to make sure that I've set up the one I want correctly. So we're going to hit F6 underneath set and make sure that graph 1 is the kind of plot that I want. I don't want a scatter plot because the points won't be connected. What I want, and you'll see you have many options. If I click this F6, you can see the other options that you can have. But I want an XY line. I want it to connect a line to all the XY coordinates, right? So that's the kind that I'm choosing. I want to verify that this is where my X coordinates are coming from in my Y coordinates, which is correct. So now I'm going to hit execute, and I want to make sure the graph is on. So select here, I'm going to turn the graph on, and notice it's on, the other two are off, and now I can just hit draw and see it. And I see my triangle. So that's how you enter a polygon. You enter its vertices coordinates, and you just make sure the first vertex that you enter it at the end as well so that the line knows to connect. So let's go here. I want to translate this original triangle. And translations are rules that change both the x and the y coordinates. So you'll see that this translation rule, as our example, is adding 2 to all the y coordinates and subtracting 3 to all the y coordinates. I think I said 2 to the x coordinates and y to the x. So let's hit back and go back to our list. Instead of retyping the list, what I'm going to do is make list 3 and list 4 be our translated triangle. So list 3 is going to be the translated x values, right? So what do we know is happening there? Well, we know we're adding 2, so I'm going to just put the heading in for myself. And what I want to do is actually make it add 2 to all of them automatically. And you do that by going up to the list title, so list 3, and I don't see any options that might help me, but that is one thing about Casio graphing calculators, is when you hit this word option, you have other choices. And so you'll see I have some other choices of things I can do while I'm up here. So I want to look for the lists. And so what I want to do is, what is list 3 actually going to be? It's going to be list 1, so I'm going to put a 1 in here, adding 2. So now I'm going to add 2. And because I'm doing it up here in this overall column, if you want to think about it, it's going to do it to everything from list 1 and add 2. So you'll see all of my values now on list 3 are list 1 where I added two. So we're going to do the same thing here to list four. And the rule for the translation rule was to subtract three. So let's just put that in our heading here as a reminder of what we did. And we're going to go back up to list four. And this time I want list two. So I'm going to hit my F1 here and I'm going to enter list two. I want list two. And what are we doing to list two? Well, we're subtracting three. And when I hit execute, it performs that operation. So we're using list operations here. Now I want to graph. So we already know what this one looks like. That's going from graph one. So I'm going to hit exit so I can, till I get back to my graph. So I'm going to go to graph. And this time I want to make sure I've set up a second graph. So I'm going to go into, so notice here it's graph one and I have graph one, but this time I'm going to set up graph two. And graph two, I want to do the same thing. I want it to be a XY line so that the vertices are connected with a line. I do need to change my list. So graph two, my X list is actually coming from list three. So notice I have to hit list here and I can enter the number. So I want it to come from list three. And so it changes that. And so let's arrow down and do the next one. And my Y list for this second graph was coming from list four. So I'm going to hit F1 for list and enter a four. And now I have set up my second graph. So let's exit. So now I have my graph set up. Let's make sure they're both on. So notice I'm going to select. And graph one is on. We do need to turn on graph two. So I'm going to just arrow down and choose F1 to turn it on. So now notice both of my graphs are on. And now I'm going to hit draw and I should see both triangles, the original and the translated one. So that's using list and list calculations to help us see what those translation rules are doing. So let's go back and you can do the same thing for reflections. Or dilations, any of that. So let's kind of arrow over, let's get another list. And this time we want to take the original and we want to reflect that over the x-axis. So what happens when you reflect? Well, the original x values stay the same, right? So we're going to just say that list five is the same. So again, I'm going to go up here, I'm going to go to my options, choose list, and I know that list five is going to be the same as my original list. So we're going to hit X, okay? But what happens to my Y coordinates? Well, my Y coordinates reflect over the X, so they become their inverse, their negative. So list six, which is my new Y, is going to be the negative of list one. So we're going to hit that. We're going to take list two, and we're going to multiply it by negative one, which will make all those values be their inverse. So now we have the reflection over here in this list. So how are we going to see what that looks like? We're going to do what we did before. We're going to go into graph. We're going to set up our third graph this time as the reflection. We still want it to be an XY. But now we have to change the lists. So our list is coming from list five and list six. So we're going to hit F1, choose the number six, execute, and then exit back till we get here. And let's turn on that third graph and let's turn off the second graph because right now we just want to look at what a reflection was going to do. So we're going to turn on the third. So now we have the original in the first and the second one in the third. So now we're going to hit execute and now we can see the reflection. So you can do transformations using statistical lists and applying the rules of transformation. So another way to think about this with students.